willkommen zu Chicken Police. Nehmt euch eure Nuggets, lehnt euch zurück und in diesem Sinne, Kakao! Okay, okay. Ja, Hobart eben besser.
So, Ibn's gone insane.
Love will kill you in the end, they say.
Seems like everyone's in a poetic mood today.
You're one to talk, by the way.
Huh? Why?
Gab's ja mal gar keine Info, interessant. Sie haben einfach nur geredet. Natascha Katsenko.
So, about that woman. Is she really that dangerous?
What woman isn't, eh?
No, Zip. I mean really dangerous.
She's got the most influential gangster of the city wrapped around her finger. She calls him her little furball. How dangerous do you think she is?
Okay, auch wieder eigentlich keine Info. Zip H. Murphy.
You didn't get any younger, pal.
You're telling me? You look like you haven't had a good night's sleep since forever.
To be honest, I've never had a good night's sleep in my life.
You will when the big sleep comes.
No. And what are your plans? Dying behind the bar?
Of course. You got a better idea?
A couple, yeah. But somehow this suits you.
You know what? Your mother's a goat.
Okay, mehr haben wir nicht. Dann quatschen wir noch mal mit ihm.
That Natasha is a mysterious woman. A real cursed jewel, if you ask me. She came out of nowhere 2 or 3 years ago and landed on the stage of the millions almost immediately.
Interessant.
Is that so? Interesting.
Sag ich ja.
She's got a fantastic voice, makes men go crazy. But we all know that's not what's important. Then suddenly, bam, she got the whole club, just like that. But we know exactly how it was.
I can imagine, yeah. Since then, it operates under the name the Czar Club, right?
The old click is still clicking, right? Yeah, the club was renamed and remodeled. Everyone knows she was Ibn's lover, but she's not your usual canary. She didn't get involved in Ibn's dirty dealings.
Then how exactly does she fit into the picture?
Check this. A few months ago, the old rat pulled out of his own businesses and gave control to Mongrel Mick and his mob.
Mongrel Mick? Doesn't sound familiar.
Mick the Marauder, ring a bell?
Damn, that little monkey came this far?
I think that little shit took advantage of Ibn not being himself.
Which has something to do with this Natasha, right?
That's my guess.
Thanks for this straight dope, Zip. We owe you one.
One? You owe me the price of a new coffee shop, remember?
Okay, okay. Whatever you need. Just call us.
I cluckin' will.
Thanks, pal.
Hey, I'm not your pal, Marty.
Okay, das war schon mal soweit ganz interessant und informativ. Haben wir jetzt für ihn noch was? Nein. Haben wir für Natascha was Neues? Nee, Natascha wollte ich. Ja. Ja, sie ist Eigentümerin des Chesar-Clubs, klar. Sie war die Gesangssensation im Millions und übernahm mit ihms Unterstützung später den Laden. Über ihre Vergangenheit vor diesem Zeitpunkt ist allerdings nicht viel bekannt. Okay. Fehlt da immer noch, das stört mich, dass die Lücke da ist. Worum auch immer es da geht. Irgendwas habe ich verpasst. Davon gehe ich mal schwer aus. Kann ich nochmal mit dir quatschen?
You sure talk a lot.
Yeah, maybe the past is haunting me. Once a rat, always a rat, right?
Oh, come on, Zippy. Don't be so hard on yourself. You got out in time, and you've been living an honest, ordinary life since then, haven't you?
Yeah, right. How lucky am I, eh?
It's more than what many others get, believe me.
Wow. Na gut. Okay, okay. Mehr haben wir dann aber hier auch nicht, ne? Gucken wir nochmal vor die Tür. Unser Gitarrenfreund. Probieren's nochmal.
Ah, poor bug eye. You mean, yeah. Yeah, if that depends.
Na gut. Tja. Da waren wir. Da sind wir. Polizeirevier von Clawville. Da geht's eigentlich nur noch Richtung Cesar Club.
Midnight had passed, and the intoxicated madness kicked in. We could only crawl along Shalva District's main street toward downtown. The city's heart beat differently. Ancient buildings were defaced by neon signs and billboards. Like half-drunk lovers on a fine leather sofa. Great old houses neighbored by garish modern blocks. A place that makes the head hurt. The Tsar's huge neon sign was visible for miles. A blazing red sign advertised tonight's main attraction, the amazing Natasha. Cops were never welcomed at places like this. They hoped we were too late for the show. We had to be inconspicuous, but it was never easy with this Bird Mountain by my side.
Ah, so this is the famous Tsar Club.
More like infamous, Marty. It's not for our kind, that's for sure. And I don't mean that they don't like foul here.
Well, at least we don't have to be afraid that they see you as a detective, Boss Bird.
Very funny, Marty.
So what are we gonna do now?
We find Natasha, the broad who sent me the message, remember? But first, we need to get into the club. And Marty, please, don't monkey this up.
Das wäre nett.
Excuse me? On behalf of the well-respected and noble primate community of Clawville?
Cut the crap, Marty. Let's focus on what we're here for, okay?
As you say, Boss Bird.
Ja, da kommt ja hier langsam auch Farbe rein, wie man hier so schön sieht. Düsenauto vorbei. Was haben wir hier alles Schönes? Okay. Oh, Louis ist hier. Interessant. Mit noch Störchen. Okay, wir fangen mal mit dem Plakat an. Oha. Okay, geht nur ums Plakat. Cesar Club. In the most colorful club of the most colorful city. Hm. My city is on fire. Okay, My City is on Fire. Das ist der Song. Der gute Song. Der sehr gute Song. A brand new hit from the Queen of the Night. Interessant, den singt doch wohl nicht die Natasha Katsenko.
You know, seeing this, I can't wait for the show.
The girls.
New Year's Eve's once a year, right? And we're not on duty.
Have I asked how Laura's doing?
Whoa, hey, I was just kidding, okay? My relationship with Laura is unwavering, like the rhino beauty on this picture.
Interesting taste you've got.
Feathers,
scales, or dermal armor, a lady's a lady, my friend.
Thank the wild gods for self-sacrificing gentlemen like you.
Hmm.
My city is on fire. This is it. It was on the flyer from Deborah. Maybe we'll get to hear it, if we're unlucky. From none other than our secret employer, Natasha Katsenko.
Vielleicht hören wir es, wenn wir Pech haben? Nee, wenn wir Glück haben.
Ah, a job with benefits, huh?
Don't be tasteless.
Oh, I get it now. The title. Do you think it's about the Great Fire of Clawville?
Besser Blitzmerker, ne?
Did you ever think of being a detective?
Ah, very funny.
My city is on. Did you?
Ah, very.
Ja. Hatten wir. Okay, was haben wir denn noch Schönes? Da geht's dann natürlich rein. Störchen kann man uns noch angucken, machen wir auch.
Honestly, I think these types of women only see faceless tuxedos, cufflinks and wallets. And in the mirror, they're just brooches, necklaces and earrings.
Don't be so radical, Marty. They're women. They live by different rules.
That was kind of deep.
It's not. Just bullshit. There's more where that came from.
Ooh, teach me, master.
When you're old and wise like me, you'll realize none of it is worth a damn thing.
Wait, that was deep again, right?
Maybe it was, Marty. Maybe it was.
Amazing.
Ihr seid schon special.
Let's not bother her.
Okay, boss.
Na, ist ja gut. Warum Louis bei ihr steht, das finden wir vielleicht gleich noch raus. Das ist der Türsteher, das Auto. Das Schild.
One day neon signs will cover the whole world, I'm telling you.
You read that in some kind of science fiction book?
No, it's just what I think.
Oh, so you have your own thoughts now. The world's really moving forward.
Pluck off, Sonny.
Wow.
The Czar Club. I'm not gonna forget this buzzing red neon light anytime soon.
Ja, ist aber geil klassisch, muss ich sagen. Okay. Es ist Limon Street. Okay. Interessant. Schicker Wagen.
Whoa, look at that. Isn't that the new...
It is, Marty. A brand new 942 Silver Hawk. Haven't seen such beauty since I left Averia.
Of all that's furry, whose is it?
Maybe it's Ibn Wessler's. I guess he's no paper tiger.
Yeah, he sounds like a fellow who drives around in one of these. Lucky bastard.
What a beautiful car.
A work of art.
Seeing it and thinking about my little rusty cubbit breaks my heart.
Don't torture yourself, Sonny. Only way we're ever gonna drive one of them is if we sign up for the mob.
Maybe it would be worth it.
I think we'd be great gangsters. In another life.
Möglich.
Beautiful car indeed. Not much else to say.
Yep. As you say, boss.
Beautiful
car. Yep.
Okay, der Werbeturm. Was haben wir hier? Na, warten wir mal auf das andere Bild. In the most colorful city. Ja, das ist wieder Werbung für den Caesar Club. 555312. Okay, A Clawville Story Boulevard. Ein Film. 555312. Mich würde tatsächlich interessieren. Tue ich's? 555312.
Is anybody there? Hello? Hello, do you hear me? Well, bye then.
Well?
It's quite the party over there.
That's good. It'll be easier to mingle that way.
If we get there in time.
Yeah, we better go.
Okay, interessant, interessant. Ich hätte sowas gerne abgespeichert, solche Telefonnummern. Ein Notizbuch wäre cool, aber habe ich nicht. Ach, ich hätte ja einfach mal...
My ex-wife.
Ich hätte ja auch einfach mal auf diesen Zettel gucken können. Auf diesen Flyer, 555312, steht doch da drauf. Wenn auch extrem klein. Okay, zurück zum Club. So. Auto hatten wir, Werbetafel.
Huh, I like this.
Why is that?
I don't know. Cause it's moving, I guess.
You're a simple bird, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Et pur si muove.
Oh, bless you.
It means, and yet it moves, bird brain. An old wolf named Galileo said that.
Oh, I see. And what did he mean by that?
Dunno. I think there was something wrong with his stomach.
Ouch.
Et pur si
muove. Oh, bless you.
Ouch. Yeah. Wenn man sich über so eine drehende Litfaßsäule so freuen kann, ne?
Do you remember when the Clawville Chronicle was a really high quality newspaper?
You mean when they wrote something about us daily?
Yeah. What exactly happened to them?
Well, they got bored with us, Marty. And to be honest, so did I.
But still, here we are working together again. Funny, huh?
Yeah. Hilarious.
Wow.
Tonight? Maybe we'll be on the front page once again.
Oh, God forbid.
Tonight?
Oh, God.
Ja, besser nicht. So, wenn ich es richtig gesehen habe, habe ich ja was für den Codex dazu gekriegt. The Global Chronicle. Der Clawville Chronicle ist die beste und meistgelesene Zeitung der Stadt. Sie ist so berühmt, dass sie auch über die Stadtgrenzen Clawvilles hinaus ihre Leser hat. Und das nicht nur in den Kolonien. Es war die Zeitung, die als erste einen Artikel über die beiden glorreichen Gockel herausbrachte. Die Geburtsstunde der Chicken Police. Dieser erste Artikel stammte aus der Feder von Timothy Saltwater. Seemöwe. Timothy Saltwater, ja. Okay. Seemöwe und rasender Reporter, der seinerseits mittlerweile zu einer gewissen Prominenz gelangt ist. Ja. Halt. So, so. Haben wir den jetzt hier schon stehen? Ne, wa? Ne, eher nicht. Na gut, na gut. Zeitung haben wir, das haben wir, das haben wir. Türsteher ignorieren wir mal. Was mit dem Fahrzeug dahinter? Okay, spielt keine Rolle. Erstmal mit Louis quatschen. Oder ansehen.
Hey, that's your old friend, right? Wait, what was his name? Lawrence? Lamar? No, Liam.
Louis. Yes, it's him.
To be honest, Sonny, I always thought that guy's not all there in the head.
Nobody's perfectly sane in Clawville, Marty. But if not for this old rabbit, I wouldn't be here today. I'll never forget that.
Should I thank him for that?
Or kill him for it?
You're reading my mind, boss.
Wow.
Is Lucas really such a big fan?
Lewis. And yes, he's got the whole Chicken Police book series. Damn his taste.
Wow, okay.
Is Lucas
Lewis?
Jetzt kann ich mit ihm reden.
Sonny, my dear friend.
Na, Lewis?
Hi, Lewis. This is my partner. But I'm sure you already know.
You have no idea how happy I am to meet you, Mr. Marty. I'm a big admirer of your work.
Pleasure's all mine, Lawrence.
Lawrence? Anyways, so, the legendary Chicken Police back together? Isn't it amazing news?
Ah, schon ein Weg.
Don't ruffle my feathers, Lewis. Those days are long gone. We're just here for the entertainment. Or something like that.
I see. That's a shame.
See you inside?
I have something to do, my pal, but I'll try to make it for the main event.
Okay, then. Catch you later, pal. Let's not bother him again.
Yes, sir.
Ja, okay, dann eben nicht. Dann bleibt uns nur noch der gute Türsteher. Ich sollte immer noch mal gucken, ob nicht irgendwo noch so ein Heftchen rumliegt. Scheint ja sowas wie Sammelobjekte zu sein oder sowas. Keine Ahnung. Auf jeden Fall mal alles absuchen. So, Türsteher.
Jeez, look at that guy.
That's not a guy. That's a demon. Straight from the dog-eared pages of a cheap detective novel.
Yeah, I bet his name's Bill.
Nah, he's definitely a Bob.
$5 for Bill?
Okay, I'm in.
Okay, Bill oder Bob?
Jeez, look.
That's not a good.
Bill oder Bob?
Howdy, pal.
Gentlemen, how can I help you on this wonderful chilly night?
We're expected in the VIP lounge.
My apologies, but I don't remember ever seeing you gentlemen here before.
Stop right there, big guy. I get it. Yeah, I know exactly how this works. So what do you have to do to get in?
Nothing's easier, sir. Are you on the list?
The list? Yeah, I've,
Don't tell me you forgot.
I'm afraid I did, Marty. Sorry, big guy, but I'm pretty sure we're not on the list tonight.
That's a shame. I'm really sorry, sirs. In that case, you can't come in.
Yeah, right. Thanks.
My pleasure, gentlemen.
Okay. Er ist immerhin eigentlich ein ganz angenehmer Typ. Bis jetzt, zumindest. Wenn er wütend wird, wahrscheinlich nicht mehr. Wo haben wir ihn denn? Nirgends. Oder bin ich blind? Okay.
Jeez, look at that's not a guy.
Ja, ja. Ich kann ihn befragen, das ist cool. Polizeimarker? Ach komm.
Look, I really don't want any trouble, but...
It is even more inconvenient for me, sir, but... This place doesn't like, coppers. Forgive this slang. I can't let just anybody in, and there are some I am strictly forbidden to. Please, you have to understand.
Listen here, you cow. Do you have any idea who we are? You ever read the papers?
Of course I know who you are, sir. I get the news and more, and I must admit it's an honor to meet you in person, Mr. Santino Featherland and Mr. Marty Machikin. The Bell of the Pantheres is one of my favorite books.
Mm-hmm.
my god, not the books again.
So it would be terribly inconvenient for me if I had to use force on you, gentlemen.
What did you just say?
Relax, Marty. This guy has chicks like you for breakfast. Thanks for the information, pal. Have a nice night.
Thank you for understanding, gentlemen. And forgive me for my austere composition.
No problem, Shakespeare.
Wow. Okay, Lewis C. Hayworth.
Say, big guy, you know Mr. Lewis Hayworth?
But of course, Mr. Hayworth is an impeccable gentleman, and also a frequent visitor of the club.
Is that so? Good to know. And?
I'm afraid that is all, monsieur.
Okay, also er ist oft da. Ist er vielleicht so ein kleiner Hinterlistiger? Ah, muss ich aufpassen. Nicht, dass er gar nicht so viel Freund ist, wie ich denke. Natascha Katsenko.
What can you tell me about the first lady of the place, big guy?
You mean Miss Natasha Katsenko, sir?
You're right on point, pal.
Nothing you don't know already, sir.
Just try me.
Well, she owns the place.
And, that's it? Well, that's, unbelievable.
Pardon, monsieur, but I'm not permitted to say anything more.
Hmm. Wow.
Just one more thing. This list of yours. Where should we sign up again?
I'm afraid if you don't know, it's not my place to tell you, sir. Excusez-moi, the regulations, you know.
You hear that, Sonny?
I do, Marty. I do.
I'm gonna lose my crest from this guy. Just wait.
Just don't get too excited, Marty. Not tonight. Anyway, thanks, pal.
Hmm. Probier's nochmal.
Yes, gentlemen.
Hey, big guy. What's your name again?
Ah ja, ganz wichtig.
My name is Archibald, sir. Archibald Conway.
Well, that's not a Bob.
Er ist kein Bob.
Excusez-moi, monsieur.
What? No way. That's not even a real name.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, sir, but my name is Archibald Conway, without any doubt. Blackjack Conway to my friends.
Well, thanks, Blackjack. It was a pleasure. We'll be on our way now.